Okay, so we're at E3 2016, PlayStation VR, and this is Riggs by Guerrilla of Killzone fame.
Yes, indeed.
And can you tell me what your game is about, please?
So, this is Riggs VR, a sports game. It's also an FPS at heart, so a lot of the controls are similar to what you will recognise from FPSs. But because it's a sports game, there's a lot of focus on different aspects of the game. We're set in the future, so roughly 50 years ahead. So it's kind of technology that you should sort of recognise, but it also is also quite futuristic, so hopefully it's all kind of fun and exciting. The mode that they're showing today is called Parathlon, which is kind of like basketball in a way. So you're going to have a big goal in the middle of the track, and you're going to try and score by jumping through it. But because we're a sports game and not an FPS, we are an FPS, but we're a sports game, as I said, you get more points from scoring these hoops than you do from taking down your opponents.
Okay.
So if you just keep run around and keep taking people out, then you'll be way down that scoreboard. You need to be scoring goals in order to be doing well in this game.
And there's an online scoreboard?
So you see all the way through the match, you'll get a half time, at which point you'll see where you are.
So is it like Speedball in the old days? Speedball 2?
In what way?
Rollerball.
It's kind of different. It is competitive, so it's 3v3. So you see your scoreboard, you see your position within your team and within the whole game.
And is this a launch game?
We're coming out straight day one, so which I think is October the 13th, I believe.
Digital?
I think we've got both. I've definitely seen a box design, and I know we're already out on the PSN store in Europe.
It's a radical jump from Killzone.
Yeah, but it's good to keep things fresh, right? I mean, it's an FPS, like I said, at heart. And
I've been playing Killzone in VR since 2013. I showed it here.
Oh, really?
In 3D, Sony. Yeah. It's a stunning game.
It is. We learned a massive amount from doing the previous FPS that we worked on. So Mercenary was one of ours. And we bought that from the ground up. We learned a massive amount from doing that one. So this is kind of like, you know, taking FPS to the next level and finding something new to go with it. So it's been really exciting working on the new IP.
It's
360.
It gets everything, him and them.
Okay, but you're not zooming in on that screen, right?
No, it doesn't have that feature.
So it's been really exciting.
There's no zoom on 360 cameras.
Yeah. Working on a new IP has been really, really fresh and new for us. You know, we took all the stuff that we kind of learned about what really works for FPSs, and we fixed a bunch of things that we found didn't work quite so well on Mercenary. And hopefully you kind of saw from here to like economy and that kind of stuff. New, exciting game. It's a departure from Killzone, and it's really colourful and really bright and really sporty as well. So that's been, really great for us, I think.
Do you still have the weight? Because I love the weight of weapons in Killzone.
Yeah, it should do. I mean, it's slightly different in that I know a lot of people find Killzone to be really heavy.
I find that really cool.
Yeah, a lot of people do prefer it. But, you know, everyone has their own preferences. There is a lot of reverb on the controllers, so you do get that feel.
How many players against each other?
It's 3v3.
3v3.
In the multiplayer, that is, but we have different multiplayer modes. So you can choose to play 1v1 with four AI bots filling the spare spot.
Hello.
Equally, you can choose to do 1v1 and then play with a friend online. Private match. Mm-hmm. We have another mode where you can have 1v1 or 1v2. So it's literally like, you know, you can invite up to six players, but you can only invite two and have a private match with them. And then in addition to that, there's like a whole single player side of things as well. So we've probably got maybe over 20 hours of like campaign mode.
Awesome.
Yeah, it's really really full game, and we try to push that it's not just this.
Can you play either side in the single?
What do you mean by either side?
Either two sides, like two corporations.
Not corporations. You pick a team in the
Reapers and Valkyrie.
There's a whole load more teams. If you check out these boards here, you can see like a good selection of our teams.
Man keeping fit.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, no yoga. This is Callie. You should be doing yoga.
Right?
Right? Everyone does yoga.
Yeah,
before you get on the plane.
I do it at work.
You do it at work?
So these are some of the teams that we have. Okay. When you play a single player mode, you choose a team and you play them for a season in the same way that you might do a football. And then with that, you have like a whole bunch of career management stuff. So you pick your co-pilots, you pick your team that you play with. Purchase rigs to play in so you build up your garage of what you want to play in. So you can choose, you know, your play style. You know, you can choose whether you want everyone to be in Tempests and you're all flying, or whether you want to be all hunters, or you can have a mix. You can have one of each. It's totally up to you.
Very deep.
So, yeah, it really is. There's a whole load of stuff you can do. We've got a bunch of stuff to do with customization as well. So as you, the more you play,
the more you customize.
The more you play, the more money you'll get, you'll earn, and that will allow you to buy new rigs. You build up a fame level, basically. So the more popular you get, the more you win, like most valuable player, that kind of thing. You get followers, and the followers, it's kind of like, you know, online, so video stuff online, you know, you get the people that have loads and loads of followers start getting sponsorship. So it's the same in
sponsorship.
We have sponsors as well. So the more popular you are, the more sponsors you have, and that unlocks customization for your pilots. So you can have different outfits.
You know what? The world's greatest rig pilot, if you call them pilots.
Yeah, we call them pilots.
It's probably going to be about 7 years old.
Well, I think technically there's an age rating on the PlayStation VR, 12 plus.
Okay, call them 12 then.
So yeah, 12's a good idea.
Because they have a better reflex. I think the world's best drone pilot is about 14
really?
Or 15.
Really?
Yeah.
This is one of our rigs. This is a thief rig, which basically means it's got a special event. So it's a Tempest. You can see the wings in the back. It's a small rig. It's 3 meters high, and we have this ability called the thief, which means that you can shoot the power orbs in the environment, the pickups. You can shoot them from further away, allowing you to pick up them more easily rather than having to run over them with the rest of them.
So have you thought of merchandising? You could probably...
Merchandising? Oh, I would love to do that.
You could collect. Just don't make them amiibo style.
I would love to have one on my desk.
Tell me. I'm sure people are probably 3D printing.
Maybe.
But PSVR just looks cool.
I know, it's really stylish. And it fits, you know, I tried...
Just tell me about it, yeah.
Yes.
It doesn't crash into your face.
No, it's just, it balances really nicely on my hair. It's really easy to adjust.
All supported there in the band. That's really clever.
And on a practical level, it's actually
expensive
as well.
Yeah. Ski mask. I told Mr. Carmack, because he knows, ski masks won't work.
Yeah, these ones, yeah, they just sit here and
hang
on. Really with glasses, that doesn't affect anything. Yeah, really.
And I can play Killzone on it in cinema mode as well. You should. I've been playing it in 3D on HMPs since that time.
Really?
We showed it here, we showed Shoes here.
Oh,
all those years ago.
Shoes a massive fan of the PSVR. He's done so much great work. To have his backing in place, I would really grateful.
I send him game recommendations.
Really?
Future Idiom? I send him that should be. 3 years ago, I sent Res in VR to Tetsuya Mizuguchi. He tweets me back now, so I tweeted him back before my demo.
Yeah, he's brilliant. Yeah, everyone loves him.
Yeah, and I've actually captured him in 360. So that was cool. Because he came to Birmingham.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I've traveled all the world. And where am I going to meet him? Birmingham.
He's visited us a few times, which is really cool as well.
So this is a very deep game. It's not just an arena combat game.
Yeah, no, definitely not just an arena combat.
Which, you know, people probably first look at it and say, another arena combat game.
So, you know, a lot of people have questioned, like, are you going to get the concurrency levels that you need to play online? Like, you know, will enough people have PlayStation VR? And actually, you know, there's so much you can do just
Did
on your
you
own
fun?
That
yeah.
I don't think it's a consideration, right? I mean, obviously, there's a whole online side of it that should be really popular, it should be really fun.
You know what happens with mech games, like FROMs, Armored Core and stuff? You get addicted to the customization more than the battle. You want the battle to be over in 5 seconds, so you can spend a couple of hours fiddling with paint.
So yeah, it's not quite down to the paint level, but yeah, you'll be able to purchase, well, as you get the sponsors, you'll be able to get new outfits. Pilot and
individual parts.
Pilots as well.
And cores and stuff, and CPUs and things, and different weapons. That's
For the rigs?
Yeah.
No, it's for the rigs. There's basically like a set number of rigs that you can purchase, and it's just a matter of how
any
much
station?
Money you have.
Oh, anyone.
Which
do you want to be on the same team as anyone? Yeah. Or
then
just pick anyone.
In terms of like co-pilots as well. So, you know, I said you could. There's aero pilots you can use to. There's like 150 different ones available. But yeah,
you've been busy.
Yeah, really busy. So yeah, they all have a name and like a face.
because Guerrilla really rock in multiplayer, even with the bots thrown in. Killzone, like the objectives would change when you're playing. It's very different to just capture the flag and, you know.
Yeah, that was a
team death.
They're really, really clever because they've had to, I mean, they had a basis, I think. We used the line engine as a basis, and they customized so much stuff to work on.
So what is that one?
This one is a Tempest, and it's a vampire ability, which basically means that as you're inflicting damage on someone, you'll be
re-energized,
healing your own ring. It's like you're taking their power and making it great. And yeah, it's got the wings for the Tempest. I think that one has double lasers.
Okay, now I want to play the game.
I have to get in our queue, I'm afraid.
I am at 4:08, so maybe,
oh, really?
maybe.
Well, you'll be here in a little bit then. We're a tiny bit behind. We are trying to catch up. We had some VIPs from where we were going.
How about Japan? They must love this, because it's mech stuff.
We've had a lot of Japanese people. We had all the Asian media come in yesterday, and they seem to really like it. So we are hearing great. We're hearing great things from all over the world. Actually, it's been a really amazing reaction. We're so genuinely, like, heartfeltly, really, massively grateful.
I really see the lineup of this diversity.
Yeah.
You've got standard games like Psychonauts, you've got Resident Evil where you sit down and play. They've really thought about, yeah, a lot of people will want to play in VR, but a lot more people will just want to play their games on a big screen. And hopefully then slowly cross-pollinate and get people crossing over.
The other really great thing about rigs that we've discovered from shows like Paris Games Week and PSX is like, if you have a social screen, you can generally stand around watching this. We got some brilliant videos, I think it was from Paris, where people were standing in the line watching these guys playing, and they were just like, you know, they were cheering people on, and like when they were getting last minute goal saves, it was like, oh man, like, oh, close. It's just, yeah, it's really great to see people reacting to it in that way that you react to like a football match or something like that. They're just choosing the rigs here, so you can see this one's a vampire, it's the same color red.
Hold it.
Okay. Yes, it's like the pins area where you've got like your teammates come up, if you look around you, it shows you what map you're playing. She looks either side, it's like base where they're fixing up the rig. But all the engineers working away. So this is where she's chosen her rig, and that's coming up from the spawn tube, and yeah, you can have a look at it, get a good close look. When you're actually in the game, I mean, these rigs, this is one of the small rigs, and it's 3 meters high.
Okay.
So, like, you know, this will be really, really towering over her. The other rig that we're showing is, there's two other ones, so there's two small ones, but it's 9 meters high. And then there's another mirage, which is 6 meters high. So the person looking at the mirage is really looking up and then
down.
These are your teammates. So it's one on the right hand side of the mirage, you'll see how much it goes. And yeah, when you're playing in that mech, in that rig, it's really, really tall. So it's really awesome. Just so far away from the field.